Hello everyone, this is Team Blue Moon. We are very happy to be a part of SIH. Let's go through the video of our prototype.
The given problem statement is to detect accidents and send alert messages to all nearby GPS-enabled ambulances and police control rooms. In our project, whenever some accident occurs, we will be finding nearby ambulances and police control rooms that are near the accident area by using some suitable algorithm. This is the main control unit, which is also known as server. This unit has GSM module, which receives the accident location from the collision detector. Then, we have used Raspberry Pi for connecting all the client units. Client units refers to the ambulance and police control units. The connection between client unit and Raspberry Pi is wireless. Raspberry Pi has an Ethernet port, which is used for connecting it to the computer. The control unit has to be supplied with 12-volt DC power. We can connect the control unit to a system or a computer and check all the details related to the accident, like accident area, available ambulances, nearby police control stations, status of the accident, that is, whether the accident area is undertaken by an ambulance or not. We have used a toy car in which we have fitted a collision detector. The collision detector has a GSM module, an Arduino, GPS module, GPS antenna, and a vibration sensor. Here we have used vibration sensor since it is a toy car. In real-time application, since the cars already have airbag module, we will be using it instead of the vibration sensor. The airbag control unit has accelerometer, vehicle speed sensor, gyroscope, brake pressure sensor, door pressure sensor, seat occupation sensor, and an airbag module. When accident occurs, the panic signal from the airbag control unit will be sensed by the Arduino, and it will send the location via GSM to the control unit. This is the ambulance control unit, police control room unit. These units will be installed with an app called Lock Tracker, which is developed by us. The ambulance unit will receive the accident location as well as the directions to the accident area. The police unit will also be receiving the details related to the accident, and also they can check whether some ambulance has undertaken the request or not. Each ambulance unit will be given a unique username and password for activating the app. Similarly, the police control units will also be given a username and password. In the ambulance unit has a toggle button. When it is in off state, it means that the ambulance is not available. So, at that particular time, the details of that ambulance will not be present in the server. When it is in on state, it means that the ambulance is available, and also the details of the ambulance gets updated in the server. On the screen, you can see that when the toggle button is on, the details gets updated in the server. When the toggle button is off, that particular ambulance unit details disappears in the server. Similarly, we can see any number of ambulance units available in the control unit screen. We can connect n number of ambulance and police control units to our server. Here's the working of our project. When accident occurs, the vibration sensor gives the panic signal to Arduino. Arduino collects location from GPS module, and in turn, it sends the location to the control unit via GSM module. This is what happens in the collision detector. The server has the status of all the ambulances and police control rooms that gets updated in real time through the ambulance unit software and police control room software. Then, the server finds all the nearby available ambulances using Haversen algorithm and sends requests to them. And the same procedure is followed by the server to send alert to the nearest police control room. Now, let's see working of our prototype in real time. We kept Ambulance Unit 1 nearer to the accident area and Ambulance Unit 2 farther from the accident area. Accident has occurred. Ambulance Unit 1, which is nearer to the accident area, receives notification, and Ambulance Unit 2 did not receive any notification since it is farther away from the accident area. Similar process is carried out to send alert to the police control room also. One thing to be noted is that alert to the ambulance unit and police control unit will be sent at the same time. In this, police control room unit 1 is nearer to the accident zone. Hence, it receives the alert signal. The police control room can also check if the ambulance has been allocated or not.
We hope you liked our video. We would like to move forward and develop our product. So, waiting for positive response. Thank you.